the voice of God sounds from the word of God. When we study God's word, when we look at God's word, the voice of God sounds from God's word. And the voice of God is a cure to the noise of life. The voice of God is a cure to the noise of sickness. The reason why that stagnation in your career is there is because it has not heard the voice of God. Once have God spoken, twice have I heard that power belong to God. So that power is surviving because the voice is not yet sounding. If you have access to the voice, you will terminate that noise. This morning, every negative voice in your life, I sound the voice of God that they are subdued in the name of Jesus. Engaging the spirit of faith for dominion. Dominion is our birthright in Christ. But if you must walk with Christ, you must operate on his platform and his terms. If you must enjoy anything in God, it is on the platform of his terms, not your terms. When you are to work in an organization, they give you a contract. These are the terms of reference. These are the things you must abide or stay put with. In the same way, level 6, without faith, it's impossible to work with God. Without faith, it's impossible. Not maybe, it's impossible. Which means without faith, dominion is not in view. The terms of God has its roots in faith. And that's why we must know what are the compartments of faith. What are the factors in faith that makes our dominion a reality? And one of them, which is key, is the spirit of faith. The spirit of faith. The spirit of faith. And how do we assess the spirit, among others? Ezekiel chapter 2 verse 2. And spirit entered into me when he spake unto me. Which means we have access to the spirit of faith. We have access to it. We have access to it. To the spirit of faith. We have access to it. The spirit entered into me. I was not a pastor when God has privileged me to be raised in the dead. So forget that too. My younger brother is still in the same line. Not because of age, because of the spirit of faith. Hear this. It takes the spirit of faith to tell someone going to hospital to come to church. Turn back from Brooklyn. Turn back. The whole family turn back. Father, mother, sisters, and brother. They all came to church. Turn back. Turn back. Even that declaration is enough to put God at turn back. What? Okay, I will show up. Turn back! Turn back! Don't go there. They will just give her drip and that will be the end. Turn back! The spirit of faith is a force. It's a force that will not allow you to rest until you see the result. The spirit of faith will not allow you to rest until you see a result. That same woman she's talking about in UK called me and said, Pastor, I'm still surprised about this cancer. No more in my body. All the way UK, I don't know her. I've never seen her. So we are engaging the spirit to secure our desired changes. Glory to God. But let me say this here quickly in 30 seconds. Should in case you have prayed, you have fasted, nothing has happened, relax. God is a God of process. For the fact that you have not seen your product does not mean that there is no process ongoing. So be very, very, and in fact, when you are walking with the spirit of faith, you are not moved about anything that is not changing. You know the end. So should in case you have not seen your change, see it in the spirit, you'll be at peace. How do we encounter the spirit of faith from the word? How? How do we encounter the spirit of faith from the word? Number one, walk in the spirit. Walk. Everybody walks every day, either by your leg or by a wheelchair. Somehow. They don't do operation at home. They don't do surgery in your house. So somehow, everybody is walking. Everybody is moving. So ensure you walk in the Spirit. Galatians 5, verse 25. The Bible says, if you are born of the Spirit, if you are born of the Spirit, live also in the Spirit. If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. If you live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. If you live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. If you are born of the Spirit, walk in the Spirit. Someone may say, how does walking in the Spirit have effects on engagement of spirit of faith? Faith is a spiritual virtue. Faith is a spiritual virtue. It takes walking in the Spirit to be able to engage the spirit of faith. I don't know what you are going through right now. For example, you are here right now, you don't know what to do with your life. It takes the spirit of faith to tell yourself there's a future for you. Everything looks blurry. Everything looks dark. But you say, no, there's a future. Everything does not look nice, but you tell yourself there's a future. No matter what they've said, you keep telling yourself there is a future. It takes that spirit to speak what you cannot see physically. It takes that spirit to speak what you cannot see. Because you see, the spirit of faith sees beyond the physical eyes. The spirit of faith sees beyond the physical eyes. When they say there's fibroid, say, which fibroid? When he said he himself took my fibroid, he took it. He took it, not that he would take it. He took it. He takes the spirit of faith to see Matthew 8:17 that he took. They say you can't be married. He said, who says so? He makes all things beautiful in his time. Exodus 3:11. He makes all things beautiful. So don't ever think that I'm going to be married. It's a lie. He's packaging me for the best husband. He takes the spirit of faith to speak what physical eyes are not seeing. Glory to God. Many of us have been caged by what men say. Many of us have been caged by men's sayings, and it's a risk for our future. If you possess spirit of faith, you will tame every negative say. If you possess spirit of faith, you tame every word not of God. You paralyze it. Hear me well. The Bible says he makes all things beautiful at his own time. Not your time. That's why what you call faith may not be what God is calling faith. And until you are on the same frequency with God, you cannot get a flow from God. Glory to God. So walk in the Spirit. But how do you walk in the Spirit? Number one. First and foremost, you cannot walk in the moon if you don't know you're in the moon. You must first acknowledge that you're a spirit. Acknowledge it. Say, I'm a spirit. I'm sure someone said, Pastor, how can I be a spirit? No, I'm alive. Don't say I'm a spirit. I'm telling you, you may be saying, ah, Pastor, it's not possible. Nobody will think like that. Somebody might be thinking like that. Pastor, I can't say I'm a spirit. I'm human. Don't say like that again. I'm human. Don't no. I don't want to die. That's not what you are saying. John 3:6. He that is born of the flesh is flesh. He that is born of the spirit is spirit. So when you got born again, you are no more a flesh. You are no more human. You are now a spirit. That's why sickness is not permitted. So when we say I can't be sick. When we say, I can't have accident, I've been driving this country for the past three years, almost 3 years plus. I've never had accident once. Not once. Not because I'm special. By the grace of God, I just have that mentality. If you remain 1 second, something will just happen. No, Not once. And you know the way accident happened in this country. It's every day. Somehow, is it that they hit you or you hit somebody? Or somebody jump robot. But you see, you just have a mentality, I can't, it's not possible. After I can't. When you settle it in your spirit, God approves it in the physical. When you settle it, I cannot have headache. I cannot be jobless. I cannot say it with authority and audacity of the word. I may not. When they say it, turn it back. Who are you talking to? There are some dreams you even have. You don't even get moved. Because many are the dreams in the sleep of a man, but the counsel of the Lord shall stand. Many are the dreams in the sleep of a man, but the reality of the word. Acknowledge you are a spirit, and the spirit will ever be in the control of humans. A spirit will ever be, not me, will ever be. Why do you think human beings are under tension of witches and wizards? They enter the spirit realm to oppress. They enter the spirit realm. No witch is more powerful than you. Mm-mm. It's because of their spiritual level. When you enter the realm of the spirit, your level determines your victory. That's why I acknowledge your spirit. But now the question is this. What is your level of your spirit? What is your spiritual level about? Acknowledge your spirit. But not ask yourself, what is my own spirit level? Where am I? Am I at the ankle level? Am I at the knee level? Am I at the loins level? According to Ezekiel chapter 47, 1 to 10. Where am I? Before I became a pastor, I didn't start using WhatsApp to raise the dead. No, there was not even WhatsApp that. I didn't start with, casting out devils just like that. No. I've shared this before, this story. The first time I ever cast out, marine spirit out of a lady. I was scared. I got up in the night, sat on the wall. Say Jesus, they are coming. Because I had the mentality that witches, they do their meeting between 12 and 3. That's the mentality I don't know who told me, but I remember that. So I sat on the wall, said, they are coming. Expecting the people I didn't give invitation to. So I sat down, I was expecting, they are coming. And the Holy Ghost spoke to me. He said, no. I have won the battle for you. I said, no, Holy Spirit, leave me alone. You only me facing this challenge. I'm serious. That was what I was talking like that. That was my level that time. I said, leave what? If I dose, I said, never, I can't dose. Blood of Jesus Christ. I was as if I was going to do physical fight. But that was my spirit level that time. That was my spiritual level that time. How many devils have I cast? And sincerely speaking, 2 weeks after, they sent a snake to me. And as the snake was about to bite me, one of my spiritual brother's friend came from the bind and smote the snake. And the snake turned to a human being. But you see, I'm telling you truth. Now, the truth is this. That was my level that time. How many demons have I cast out? Thousands. Several after that. Several. But you see, when I do it, I don't look back. It got to a point, when I got to a level, when I cast out devil, I will get home, I'll go and speak with the blood of Jesus Christ. The blood. The guys, they come to my house. That was a level. But I've learned that level. When I cast out demon, I say, are you still remaining? That is the level now, by the grace of God. You must check your level to know where your faith is. Change your level. It got to a point that when somebody came to my office, she was having fun, and I was eating almond nuts. That was when I was in Ibadan. I was eating almond nuts. I said, take this almond, and I was taking almond nuts and malt. I don't really eat. So I gave the take almond. The one I was eating, I gave to her. After I gave it to her, that was the end. That's all. I said, eat it. That's all. Now, check, acknowledge your spirit, and also check your level of your spirituality. Not all declarations are permitted from your mouth. Not all. Don't tell somebody you will see when you don't know what to show. Don't tell a Sangoma you will see When you don't have a backup, you will back up. Change your spirit level. Don't just talk. Talk from depths. Talk from the source. Make sure your horse is getting the source to get water. Glory to God. How do you walk in the spirit? Surround yourself with spirit-minded people. Spirit-minded people. Those who are so conscious of spirituality. Not just for facial values, but practically. Surround yourself with those who are determined to be spiritual. Surround yourself with those who speak spiritual things. That's how to walk in the spirit. People that every statement carries God's presence. Every statement carries. There are some people when you enter the midst, your faith will die. Your faith will just die. By the time you left the, you enter the place with 30% of faith, you leave the place with minus 30. Because the one you have, they kill it. They will not put many doubts inside you. Hear this. That fear in you that is harassing you before now dies now. Amen. I heard that at the beginning of the service. There's somebody here. There's something that is threatening you heavily. Heavily. I heard it. That reminds me now. This week, that thing will disappear as if it never existed. Amen. Whatever is causing fear in your heart, whatever is bringing tension on you, I speak with the authority of God that before Wednesday 12 noon, it has turned to a testimony in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. It is done. It is done. It is done. It is done. The company you keep, as well aware, is what that means, what accompanies you. Psalm 1, verse 1 to 3. The company you keep determines what accompanies you. So if you're in the midst of those who talk faith, you also talk faith. If you're in the midst of those who talk doubt, you also talk doubt. And when you talk doubt, you are out. You are out of blessings, out of favor, out of divine intervention. You are out. So don't talk doubt. Don't stay in the midst of those who are doubting. Glory to God. But how do we encounter the impartation of the spirit of faith from anointed carrier? How? How do we encounter the impartation of the spirit of faith from an anointed carrier? Because the truth is this. God is a God of order. 1 Corinthians chapter 14 verse 40. God is a God of order. You cannot know more than God. And you cannot order God to alter his order. God is a God of order. Anointing will always flow from the top. Jeremiah chapter 3 verse 15 and 16. He said, I will give you pastors according to my own heart. Not your own prerogative, my prerogative. I will give you. You don't determine. You don't determine. I will give you. I will give you according to my heart. So God determines where your anointing comes from. God determines how you assess your anointing. You may go and put your head under a man of God that God has not sent you to. I'm telling you, you carry a curse. Because that's not the best God sent you to. Why is everybody not having one church? God is a God of order. Some Baptist, some Orthodox, Pentecostal, but God, same God. So, how do you encounter impartation of the spirit of faith from an anointed carrier? Number one, believe in the ministry of the carrier. Believe in that ministry. What does it mean? Believe that God gave him an assignment for you. Believe that God sent the person to you. Believe that he carries a message that will turn every of your mess to a testimony. Believe that the person is sent of God. See God in the person. Like I told some of our people, some a moment ago that if it was God that spoke to you this way, is that the way you react? Assuming, hear me and hear me well, assuming you see God standing like this and talking to you, you won't be like this again. It's because we see men speaking. That's why things are not changing. When we start seeing God in the men of God, we will overcome every of our challenges. When we start seeing God in the men of God, stop. Remember when I first came, I used to say this statement, that if you see me, you miss it. But if you see God in me, you get it. If you see me, this short boy, this, what is he looking for? If you see me, you miss it. People have come to my office. One woman of God in this environment, in this Pretoria, big church. They had some challenges. So I think she has heard about the young chap and came. And when she came, she knocked my office. And when she entered, she was confessing this after the whole story. She said, as she entered, she said, is this the person they are talking about? She almost turned back. I know, it can't be this one now. She was expecting to see a huge, big man of God. I'm telling you, I'm not lying. That's what she said. She was expecting to see a big man. I said, small boy, what will he do for me? Any man of God, you don't celebrate the grace he carries, can never be a blessing to you. No matter the height, no matter the size, no matter the age, believe the ministry. Believe that God gave him an assignment. 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 20. The Bible says, believe the Lord your God, it shall be established. Believe his, not his in the prophet matters. His prophet, not just prophet, his. You know, Christianity has been bastardized now. We know so many stories now flying everywhere and there. You know, dead being raised and stuff like that. That is now making the real dead that are raised to become fake. But it's fine. God will have mercy. Because when you do evangelism now, that there is a dead guy, is a lie running. Because if we ever say now, they say, Pastor, are you this person? Don't go there again. Why? Because the fake and the original, they are competing. And the fake is winning. And the fake is now manipulating the mind of those who are supposed to believe. If they don't believe, they say, no, it's not possible. But we will not announce it. God will announce it. That's the point. The doer will prove himself. That's my own understanding. The doer will announce it. I don't need to say, the doer will announce himself. If I did it, I will announce it. But if God is the one doing it, let's see. Very simple. Because now, the environment is now so porous. Terrible infiltrator with negative thoughts and manipulations. As a result, when you preach, they say, no, Christianity, no, no, no. But I know God will prevail in South Africa. And God will fully expose every worker of evil in this country. So believe in the ministry of the carrier. Hallelujah. If you believe, you attract. If you believe, you will attract the grace. Hear this. Faith is magnetic. Faith is magnetic. That is, faith has magnetism. Has the potentials to magnetize your blessings. When you believe in the carrier, the power in the carrier delivers your desire. The Bible says, the woman with your blood said, if I may but just touch the hem of his garment, I shall. The faith in her magnetized the healing she desired. Faith is magnetic. It attracts your blessings uncontrollably. Even devil is helpless. The devil that stopped her for 12 years could not stop her faith in 30 seconds. So believe. Believe. If faith, power can reach Congo, power can reach UK, power can reach Israel, power can reach Qatar on phone, how much less here? Glory to God. Okay, what are the proofs of impartation of faith? Or what is the proof of impartation of spirit of faith? The spirit of faith is a driving force that makes unimaginable moves. Unimaginable moves. You make some moves that validate that this is not you. It's a driving force. It's a driving force that makes unimaginable moves. Sincerely speaking, I'm saying this again. I didn't know when I said turn back. I've said it before. I recognize that. Ah, turn back. Eh? From hospital. Am I, is this hospital? But something just made me say, turn back. How can you tell people to turn back from hospital and come to church? When is it somebody is, I mean, was lifeless. But the spirit of faith knows the end and declares according to the end that it knows. It drives you. It drives you. Go and buy that property. Go and apply for that job. It drives you. Make attempts. You can't claim you have faith and you remain the same. It's a lie. Mark chapter 1 verse 12. The Bible says, and the Spirit driveth him into the wilderness. The Spirit drove him to the wilderness. And look at Mark chapter 2, verse 1. 1 to 12. The Bible says that it was noise abroad that Jesus Christ has entered, you know, a particular city. And as he entered, the house was full. Mark chapter 2, from verse 1 to 3 downward. And they all gathered there. And eventually, see what happened. The place was full, no space. And the people that carried the man with palsy, they said, what do we do? They went to look for a ladder, look for a carpenter, open the roof, remove the nails, remove the ceiling, got a ladder, lower the man down. Even if you are God, you will heal the person. There was no space, but the spirit of faith drove them to take a step against every negative effect. To take a step. So, the spirit of faith drives you unimaginably. I would like you to ask yourself, that situation around you, what step have you taken? In your career, have you taken any dangerous step? Have you taken any step that people are saying that, what is your own? Is it not too much? Have you taken any step to prove that something is doing you? Something is moving you. Review it. And this week, a testimony will follow. Amen. Shout a better amen. Amen. Shout a better amen. Amen. Shout a better amen. Amen. By the spirit of faith, you are taking all that is yours in Christ this week, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Your career is settled this week. Amen. Your business is expressing a change this week. Amen. Your finance is expressing a change this week. Amen. It's not enough to say amen. Take step. Take step. Go and activate anything you have had. Appropriate what you have had towards your desire. And this week, your testimony shall be delivered. Amen. Quickly, this morning is our service of marital breakthrough. Current day of marital breakthrough. Shattered marital destiny is a major plague in the body of Christ today. And behind this is satanic oppression. Shattered marital destiny is a major plague in the body of Christ, especially in this our environment. Is a major plague where a man will just be going and just pick a lady, hum, I'll marry you. Just like that. Not even caring about the source or whatever. If he's carrying demonic cause, it doesn't matter. As if you are doing, you know, cartoon. Just pick a lady on the street. Sleep with anything, as if anything goes. Not knowing that you are slipping away your destiny gradually. Psalm 68, verse 6. God set his solitary in families. So God is the maker of families. Stop trying to make it by yourself. God is the maker. But Matthew 13:28 says, an enemy has done this. If you look at it, ask yourself, in my family, marriage, is it something nice? Is marriage something good? Has the devil not planted negativity in our marital destinies? The devil not work evil in our lives? Any marriage that is going through challenge, any marriage that is not going straight, this morning the Lord will restore you. Anyone in a cage of marital spell, the more you try to marry, the more you get a wrong person. The more you try to make attempts, the more they dupe you or they rob you or whatever. This day, everyone on the line for marital breakthrough, God is setting you free in the name of Jesus Christ. Shout a better amen.
Amen.
Shout a better amen.
Amen.
Shout a better amen.
Amen.
If your father has it all, you can't lack it at all. If your father lacks, I mean, have it all, you can't lack it at all. Your father has everything. Your father has everything. So you have access to everything. Anyone here that is desiring a marital change, I mean, change their marital lives, please do well to position your mind to the change you want. You want to be married? Put your mind in it. Lord, send my word that will get me married. You want your home to have peace or progress? Lord, send the word of peace. Maybe there's a spell of marital stagnation in your family. Lord, break it right now. Make sure your heart is panting. Today is my day. Today is my day. Keep saying it to your spirit, man. Be so desperate that marital siege is broken. Be so desperate that today, man, don't be distracted. And watch it. In the twinkle of an eye, God will settle you.
Amen.
Shout a better amen.
Amen.
And that's why a word encounter is a covenant key to our deliverance. A word encounter is our covenant key to our deliverance, no matter our situation. I will not forget September 18, 2009. I was sleeping. Pa, pa, pa. I don't know who woke me up, but no human being. The same power that established Feta Banaku within 1 year will establish your marriage in 1 year. God told me that. I'm not praying. I said, God told me. But it's for you as well if you believe. Now, God spoke to me like that. I was sleeping. Bah, bah, bah. And I look at my left, my right. Ah. Immediately I heard that word. Psh, 1 Timothy 1:18. This charge I give unto you, son Timothy, concerning the prophecy that have gone ahead of you, that might test by them what a good offer. I put in prayers. And I said, did. I said, wait. I don't know anybody now. Who do I know? I said, how shall this be? Since I know no man. And he said, that's this person. Ah, this person can. No, it can't be you. This one, I brought her up in school as a spiritual father. Well, how can I now be? Wouldn't they think that that's your platform? I'm telling you, that's what I was thinking. But God said, that's it. And I pick up my phone. But it was an encounter with God. Not that you are my butter in my bread. You are the sugar in my tea. You are the, you know, not that. Picked the phone and called. And as I called, before I finished talking, I didn't want to do any toasting. I don't know how to toast. If I want to toast, it's Bible that will come out. Before I finished talking, he just said, yes, God told that 2 weeks ago. That's the end of discussion. Like I keep saying, if they say you are the butter in the bread, they will soon eat you. If you are the sugar in the tea, they will drink you. And if you're the cockroach in the cupboard, they will kill you. So when you hear that, say, eh, I'm your cockroach. Run away. Because those things that enter your brain, they are draining your future. You are the butter. Hey, you see, he called me the butter. Ah, butter. You will soon enter this large intestine. Because they will eat you. But if you have a word encounter, a definite encounter from God, I've been married now since that time, no challenge. I've never called my in-laws. Hello, see you, see what now? What are you seeing? Like I told a couple some days ago, I said, when you want to have this thing, you want to do together, do you call them? Come on, want to start home. If you don't call them at home, want to start, why should you call them? She shouted. Yeah. When you want to do this thing, you don't call them. We want to start to come and pray for us or check. Now, but when she shouts, or you don't say, come on, see your daughter, see your son. If you can manage this one, manage that one. That's wisdom. If you can manage this, that is the wisdom of stabilizing your home. If you, both of you can be calm when you want to do it, be calm when the other one is to be calm too, and calm yourself down. And they come, okay, we can't shout. You know, when we do this, we don't shout. So this one, let's not shout. Okay, what is the matter? See, I'm telling you, if you can understand it that way, there won't be issues again. Nobody ever called the in-law that come, oh, we want to start. So please quickly keep on in prayers. That's why when you encounter the word of God, it balances your life. When the word is the foundation, that's why I tell people, don't just get married because somebody is pretty. But unless you end up in the pit of that pretty lady. You end up in the pit of the pretty lady. What encounter is a force that stabilizes homes. What encounter? Ask yourself, which word did you receive to marry that lady? What did God tell you? Except those who are lying. See, God told me when I went to the mountain. He said, you are the one that will marry you. Even the way they are saying, you know that, he rolled. The way they are shaking their head, see, God told me that if you are bored, I pick my phone, hello, I've not finished talking. God told me 2 weeks ago. Simple, because it's the same God. God told A this, he told C, D. He can't walk, it's a lie. Desire your wife from the world. You have a lasting result. Desire your husband from the world. You have a lasting result. Every home having itching in this service. Peace is restored in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes. Shout a better amen. Yes. Shout a better amen. Yes. Shout a better amen. Yes. It is your right to have a good home. It is your right in Christ to have a peaceful home. It is your right in Christ to have a peaceful home. It is your right. It is your right because they call his name Prince of Peace. So if you are born again, Prince of Peace lives inside you as husband. If you are born again, Prince of Peace lives inside you as wife, then what is the matter? Then you have double Prince of Peace. Then where should there be turbulence? Why? Where? How will it come? I've never shouted at my wife, and I will never. I'm telling you my own personal choice. I will never, not because I don't want to, I can't. A whole human being, dang. I'm telling you the way I picture women, as in my own wife. Nah, I'm scared because I see God in that woman. I don't see her character. I don't see her behavior. God gave me. I should refer to God, not to God. That is the way to make your home work. I'm telling you the truth. I'm not saying it to please anybody. I'm saying by that was what I understood before I got married. Before I got married at all, I said, God, you gave me a whole human being. Whole. Even if they give you a dog, you celebrate. They don't give a whole human being. Like, whole. That one is so big in my eyes. I'm telling you, it really helped my marital life, sincerely speaking. Because I got it from the Lord that I gave you a human being, a gift. Not a turtle or a robot. If we change our perspective towards marriage, things will change. See marriage from God's perspective. You enjoy the best of marriage. See marriage from God's perspective. God said, it's for a man to be alone. Let's make him an helpmeet. That is, they are to be helping each other, not dominate each other. Not wife, nor husband. Helpmeet. You are in the same class. He took her from your rib as a partner, not as a partner, not as a molester, as a partner, not a manipulator. When some wives manipulate their husband, they say, is it not your husband? Oloshi. Your husband Oloshi. When you call your husband Oloshi, you are Oloshi too. Because Oloshi must marry Oloshi. What's Oloshi? I don't know. Oloshi. I don't even know the English of Oloshi. Oloshi is... please, what's Oloshi? Eh? Useless. Okay, useless. Thank you. Say, useless husband. Mrs. Useless. So, if you call your wife or husband useless, you are also Mrs. Useless. So, the name you call your husband is the feminine name that you bear. You, this goat. Mrs. Goat. Carry that mentality. It's not funny. It's not funny. It's what you should carry in your mind. And any family going through challenge, today is the last day. Peace is restored in the name of Jesus Christ. And in case you are here, you are here to be married. Your father is a marriage maker. You can't be a single forever. Your father is a marriage maker. He said, Genesis 2:18, it's not good for a man to be alone. He said, let's make him an helpmeet. Let's make him an helpmeet. Helpmeet for him. For him. For him. Not against him. Stop seeing your wife as a witch. If he's a witch, cast that spirit out. Witchcraft is a spirit, not a human being. So say, witch, leave this body now. He goes, then wife comes back. Then marriage continues. Simple. Then he's a witch. He's a, okay, witch, what do you do about it? You need to do something. God is a marriage maker. You can't lack wife. But the question is this. Many of us are not looking for wife or husband in God. We are looking for wives and husbands in the world. Whatever you don't get from God cannot last forever. And that's the challenge of many of us in the society. Many of us got our wives. It might be from church, but the person is not godly. It might be from church, but it doesn't know any. Like I was sharing with Mosley some time ago, last week, after the service, I met some individuals. After third service, I said, what did Pastor preach today? I said, I'm blank. What did Pastor preach today? Pastor Kai. Today, now, not yesterday, today. Just measure even, just faith. Faith, just say faith. Now, how do you now know you came to church? That you came. How will you know you came? When you cannot even recognize one word. Hence, when you are to locate husband, locate the one in God. One in Jesus. Locate a wife in God. People see me talk much on marriage. I mean, so firm about marriage. Because they feel I'm too firm or I'm tough. I'm not tough. Go and see those rich are rough. You know why I'm tough. Check it out. Many homes are getting bastardized. Because devil knows once he gets homes, he has gone in the church. The church is a combination of families. So when families are being attacked, the church is attacked. And that's why we are emphasizing on families being settled. Families being restored. Families being delivered. Every family in this service shall be delivered in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Shout a better amen. Amen. Shout a better amen. Amen. So, what do you do to actualize your glorious marital destiny. How do we actualize our glorious marital destiny? Number one, remain in love with God. Remain. Don't just start it. Remain in love with God. Romans 8:28. For we know all things work together for the lovers of God. All things. Remain in love with God. I never knew I would marry my wife. She was one of the people that I used to, you know, gather to worship God in school. When she was in 400 level, me I was in 200 level. And because me, I've gone to other schools. You know, she did WAEC once and enter. You know, some ladies are quite brilliant, you know, but some guys, it is well. But nevertheless, that's not the point now. I went to like other schools, and by the time I got to school, she was already 400, me I was in 200 level. But that time, I would be guiding people in school to come and worship God. So I never knew I was gathering my destiny. I would go to male hostel, female hostel, come and worship Jesus, come and worship God. We'll be screaming. Everybody on that, they call the place Fadama. They know my ass. Scream, worship God. And I never knew that she was one of the people. I mean, she's the person I was ever married to. She was dating one sister, Brother Tunde, for 3 years. I was even encouraging her, marry Bratunde. Bratunde will have a good future. Bratunde is do. I was encouraging, you know, Bratunde is as a, you know, Bratunde is nice. Bratunde is, you know, like, she opted out of the marriage like twice, out of the relationship like twice. I push her back, enter. I didn't know I was pushing away my destiny. I thank God. I turned back. I said, marry Bratunde. He said, it's me she will come and report to. It's Bratunde, it's Bratunde. I said, relax. You see, life is not like that. I didn't know I was encouraging what it would take. But it was the love of God. I was genuine. God sees my heart. I was not doing because of personal things. The person I have been is who I am. Is still the person I am. Encouraging her to marry Bratunde, but I didn't know that I was pushing my destiny away. But eventually, God pulled her back by a phone call. And immediately I called. She said, yes, God talk. But you see, thank God for the foundation of 6 years. The love of God brought us together. Not the love of sex. Not the love of, I like your shape. Which shape? When poverty comes, shape will turn to one. So if you allow shape, that's why many marriages are not lasting. It was shape. Shape brought the person. But when poverty is setting, shape turn to shame. So be careful of shape. Shape can cheapen your life. Cheapen your life. Why? Because shape may not last. But the love of God will be forever. I told my wife at the beginning of the marriage, I said, now, hear this, I don't love you. I love God. If a woman misbehaves, you can hate her. Passionately. Yes, but you can't hate God. I thought I love you. I love God. As long as my love for God remains hot, my love for you is unchanging. Mess up, it doesn't change. My love for God remains forever. When you mess up, I go to God. God, what's going on? Very simple. It's not just take it easy. There's nothing that goes up that will not come down. There's nothing that is big that will not become small. Relax. That, I'm telling you. You see, that's why foundation of understanding matters a lot. These were the basic things I understood before I got married that really helped me. No matter what happens, it doesn't mean I should not. And anyone that carries the love of God is being monitored by God. When the love of God dominates your heart, you can't misbehave. Look at what the Bible says, Romans chapter 5, verse 5. The love of God has, I can't remember the exact chapter. He said, the love of God has constrained us. The love of God has a way of constraining you against you. That's why the Bible now says in Romans 5, 5, the love of God has been shed abroad in our heart by the Holy Ghost. When it's in our heart, it constrains us. You want to act, you can't act because there's something inside you that will not allow you to act.
You want to decide
who to marry. Because of the love of God, you see somebody poking, you say, no, I will change. You can't change a man, no, you will fail. No, you will change now. No, pastor, you see, he's been coming to church. Shut up. Until he changes genuinely and established with proofs. Many are falling victim of this nonsense mentality. He will change. He will change. Who told you? Are you God?
Nobody can change anybody except God. So don't ever say he will change. Let him change with a proof of 3 to 6 months.
People have deceived others for 6 months.
Playing pride.
Knowing fully well that once I get her, I will endure. I will endure. I will endure. I will endure. Devil is a master planner.
Your destiny is heavier than that lady.
Stop it. No, don't worry. You see, we serve the same God. To be a Muslim and a Christian, it doesn't matter. Oh, hell is knocking at your door.
Please be conscious of your steps. Let the love of God determine your actions. Let the love of God determine your ways.
Let the love of God determine your decision. Ask yourself, will God take this step? Very, very important. We're not perfect, but we can embrace instruction to grow us into perfection. We are not perfect, but if we embrace instruction, we'll grow into perfection. Let me mention one point as we close in this service.
Engage the power of faith to secure a change
you want in your marital destiny.
Engage the power of faith.
Mark 9:23. Engage the power of faith.
Faith can change anything. If thou canst believe, all things are possible to him that believeth. If you want to marry this year, it's possible. You want your husband to be responsible, it's possible. You want your wife to be responsible, it's possible. You want your family, your children to be well, it's possible. Embrace the spirit of faith. Engage the force of faith, it's possible. Faith is a tool.
Multifaceted use. You can use it in different ways. To get husband, I said, God, woke me. He said, this time next year, you are getting married. Ha! How shall this be? I don't know any woman. I don't know who. I'm telling you, I got married the same date God gave me. Just a year after. Just a year as he said it. As he said it, against all odds. Against any money or no money. Against how much of my salary. Against everything. Because when God speaks, God's hand is there to manifest it. When God speaks, God's hand is there to manifest it. And in this service, every of your desire in your marital life is coming to pass in the name of Jesus Christ. Yeah. You are here.